You're listening to the audio production of Lose It for Life, The Total Solution, Spiritual, Emotional, Physical for Permanent Weight Loss, by Stephen Arterburn and Dr. Linda Mintle, published by Thomas Nelson, and read by Brandon Batchelar.
Getting started. If you are struggling to lose weight or to keep off pounds already lost, you are in good company. Obesity is a veritable epidemic in our society. Nearly 65% of American adults, or more than 120 million people, are considered overweight or obese. And despite billions of dollars spent on countless diet books and health products, we Americans are more overweight than ever. To be overweight or obese means to have a medical condition caused by an excess of body fat. By general definition, you are overweight if your body mass index, or BMI, is between 25 and 29.9. Obese is if it is above 30. And while these terms can be easily defined and measured through a number of techniques, most of us need only look in the mirror or stand on the scale to know if we are in trouble. Samuel Klein, president of the North American Association for the Study of Obesity, notes that technically advanced societies with an abundance of food and sedentary lifestyles are especially at risk for producing overweight people. The speed at which this is happening in America is reason for concern. If you are like most people, you are probably trying to lose weight right now, or you are at least thinking about it. And while losing weight seems like an uphill battle in which the mountain is never fully climbed, it is in truth a battle that can be won. It is our hope that this book is the last one you'll ever have to read concerning the topic of weight loss. We know most of you have stacks of books you've purchased over the years that detail all sorts of angles and fads for shedding unwanted pounds. Each of those diet books represents your good intentions to conquer that mountain. But for reasons only you know, you haven't won that battle. Yet. Perhaps you know someone who is losing weight on the fad diet of the day, or maybe you were trying yourself. After a while, were you right back where you started, or in even worse shape than before? It's a familiar story, and it's likely that you are reading this book with a bit of mistrust or skepticism. Let us reassure you that it's okay. We aren't here to help you embark upon another failure. We don't want to promise hope and not deliver. We want you to be successful, to lose weight for life. Actually, losing weight isn't really the issue. Your closet full of multiple-sized clothing is testimony to the number of times you've lost and gained weight in your lifetime. Some of you are experts at weight loss and could write your own books about your experiences, eating grapefruits, downing vats of fat-burning cabbage soup, consuming liquid shakes, protein bars, low-fat brownies, and low-carb ice cream. Our personal favorite is the diet in which you lose weight by breathing differently. It's enough to make us all crazy. We Americans are tempted by quick fixes. The problem with quick weight loss ideas is that they don't work for very long and require drastic changes in the way we eat, changes that are impossible to maintain over time. Some fad diets are even dangerous and can lead to serious health problems. Recently, I, Steve, was sitting in an airport with executives from my publisher. We were reviewing the cover for this book when the woman at the table next to us overheard our conversation. She wanted to know which diet we thought was the best and asked if Lose It for Life was a healthy plan. She explained that she had just quit a diet because of her health. Though she had lost weight, her cholesterol was at 148 and manageable when she started the diet. However, after only a short time, she was forced to take medication to get her cholesterol under control and had to stop using the particular diet. She is only one of many who have hurt their health while trying to lose weight the wrong way. The real issue isn't if you can lose weight. You can. But can you lose weight sensibly and keep it off? Can you lose it for life? The answer to both questions is yes. There is no foolproof diet. Look around. For all our obsession with weight loss gimmicks, we continue to experience record rates of obesity. We must change our lifestyles, learn to eat sensibly, and exercise. This doesn't sound exciting or terribly new, but it is a long-term strategy that works. and this book can help you make change happen. We encourage you to try again if you've struggled or failed with other methods of weight loss. And if this is your first time trying to lose weight, welcome. We'll share what we know from both personal and clinical experience. I, Steve, used to weigh 60 pounds more than I do today. I know the heartache of losing the weight, feeling great, and then losing control and gaining it all back. I know how it feels to essentially carry around the equivalent of a third grader on my person. And I know the horror of another approaching summer when everyone will be in a swimsuit and I will have no place to hide. For years, I felt like a second-class citizen because I was fatter than any of my friends. But I was more than that. I was unhealthy. My blood pressure was so high that I was on medication while I was still in my early 20s. I was out of breath and out of energy most of the time. I couldn't run around the block, even at a slow jog. I was facing an early death. And just like you, I had a brain that functioned. My weight problem was not a result of lacking IQ points. The problem went deeper. It was emotional and spiritual. There was within me a stubborn resistance to do what would eventually change my life. For a long time, I counted on my troubled mind that had gotten me into trouble to get me out of trouble. I tried the same old tactics over and over again, only to fail over and over again. But fortunately, I awoke one day, sick and tired of being sick and tired. My life was never to be the same again. I had experienced a spiritual awakening that led to a new willingness to change. Based on those changes, I developed the Lose It for Life plan. Not a diet, but a plan that can work with any diet. Not a behavioral plan that leads to a temporary change in the way you look, but a healthy plan to address spiritual and emotional needs at the core of your being. The Lose It for Life plan is really a strategy for a healthy life. I've been living by it for years, and the results in my own life have been profound. I've seen what poor eating habits can do to a person. My father was a great man, but he didn't know how to eat. His cholesterol was horrible, and he was on blood pressure medication, just as I was in my early 20s. He died at 68 of a massive heart attack. It broke my heart because I had so many plans for us over the years that would have followed. Because I was a sitting duck for the same health problems, I gave up some old family eating patterns and adopted the Lose It for Life plan. So far, so good. I just had an annual checkup, and my blood work was fantastic. Not one indicator was above or below normal. And the indicators for heart disease showed that I was at 1/4 the risk for heart disease compared to other males my age. I look forward to a long future, and I hope to hear one day that you have experienced the same results. These radical life changes began from a spiritual place within me, a place of surrender that led me to a new willingness to do whatever it took to get the weight off. I began to lose the weight and have kept it off for more than 20 years. That same willingness to learn and heal and change is the same willingness I try to instill in the hearts of those people who attend the Lose It for Life Institute I have conducted biannually for the past few years. People have paid $1,600 to attend the conference and often had to buy 2 airline seats to come. That was just for one person. Many have tried everything. Some are on their 3rd gastric bypass surgery. But even after having paid all of that money and going to all the trouble to attend, they often come with little willingness to change. By the end of the 5-day experience, there is real change and they are on a different path. We have followed up with attendants to discover that many do lose weight. I have learned much from those who attend these institutes. Others haven't lost weight, but have changed their lives and are actually living for the first time. And sadly, there are also those who make no changes and continue down the same path as before. Lose It for Life is the culmination of a lifelong journey of first having a weight problem, then finding a way to be free of it for life, and sharing the method of that victory with others. I also bring with me 30 years of experience of working with fellow strugglers of all types of addiction and dependency. and I, Dr. Linda, bring more than 20 years of personal experience working with clients' eating disorders and food and weight problems. Over the years, I've worked with hundreds of people who have tried all kinds of diets, felt the agony of defeat, been stigmatized because of their weight, endured shame and humiliation due to their size, and felt hopeless in terms of overcoming the compulsion to overeat. I've consulted with low-calorie diet programs, completed pre-surgical evaluations for patients considering surgical treatment for obesity, and been instrumental in reviewing medication options for patients. I've spent countless hours with patients in individual, marital, family, and group therapy sessions for eating disorders, including those struggling with compulsive overeating and binge eating. All that to say, I've heard your stories and witnessed the tremendous effort you've put forth to lose weight. Personally, I struggled with my own weight during a traumatic time in my life. Following the death of my oldest brother, I unconsciously used food to soothe my cycling emotional state and deal with his passing. At the time, I had no idea that my eating was connected to my emotional pain. My training as a therapist and faith in God helped me make this connection and gradually lose the excess 30 pounds. I've maintained that weight loss for 20 years. We intend to be practical, helpful, insightful, and spiritually alert. We want you to be successful, and we want to help you lose weight without feeling shame, guilt, pressure, or condemnation. Though the weight loss journey isn't easy, it is possible to lose weight and keep it off. You can lose weight for life. Lose It for Life, or LIFL, is not about dieting. It's not about exercising, although exercise does play a part. There is no quick fix, magical diet, or even the promise of a thin body. Losing weight and keeping it off has more to do with changing how you think, feel, and act at any given moment, rather than what you eat or whether you take part in a regular exercise program. Lose It for Life is about creating a lifestyle of permanent weight management that emphasizes the whole you, your spirit, mind, body, and emotions. It is about discovering meaningful connections with others, support, and community. Spiritual renewal and transformation, an important part of LIFL, are not typically part of weight loss programs. Yet without both, you will struggle to keep weight off. It is through a deeper relationship with God and others that hope and encouragement will flood your soul. When you read the word spiritual, what do you picture? Do you envision an angry fundamentalist who throws rules and regulations at you while grinning insincerely? Or perhaps you think of some esoteric experience that no one ever really gets? If you can relate to either of these scenarios, you're in for a pleasant surprise. We want to help you understand authentic spirituality, and also to examine why the counterfeit of that very thing may be keeping you fat. You are a physical being, and a diet may help you address that. But you are also a spiritual person from the inside out, and it is in that core of you that the battle is fought and then won or lost. We are going to help you with that spiritual battle. Have you ever found yourself saying, "All I have to do to lose weight is..." It's a common lie that most of us who have struggled with weight loss have told ourselves, that if we change just one thing, the weight will go away. We want to believe that there is a simple solution to our very complex problem, but there isn't. Instead, there are many variables within your own personal equation to consider. With the help of this book, and by combining the necessary components to maintain your weight management lifestyle, you will form a personal plan for living a healthier life. Be encouraged, because you can lose it for life. There are so many positive reasons to go forward. Losing it for life is exciting and completely possible. Commit to these 10 positive reasons to begin this journey as you, 1, improve your health. As you gain a proper view of food and nutrition and become more active, you will lose excess pounds. Research shows...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.